What's up, guys? This is Aya Issa, and you're watching Ahyat Property TV. Thank you so much for tuning in. And you're watching part 8 of a 12-part video series that I'm doing specially to review Malaysia's budget 2015 and how it impacts the property market. So we've looked into strategy 1, strategy 2, strategy number 4. And what's next? We're going to skip 5 because I don't find anything that's going to have a direct impact to the property market. It's strategy number 3 and 5. Let's look straight into strategy number 6, youth transformation. Now, you wouldn't think that, hey, you know what, there would be something that would impact the property market under strategy 6, youth transformation, but I did find something very, very interesting and I think very innovative of the government of the day. So this is the 6th strategy, developing national youth transformation program, and I found a series of amazing points, items under the budget text of 190 items, but we're looking into item 127, 128, 129, 130, 131, and 132. So 127 2 right up to 132. So what did it mention? Now, in item 127, the government mentions this very innovative kind of thing, which they call, right here, you could see my cursor right there, is One Malaysia Youth City with an allocation of 100 million to fund 3 pilot projects in the peninsula, Sabah and Sarawak. So I'm excited about that. One Malaysia Youth City, which the government is going to try to help the youth, you know, try to help them with home ownership, right? So what else did they say? Okay, so one item 128. Now you see this is the 2 parts into it, right? So the first part talks about the youth city, and the second part about under the 6th strategy, it mentions 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, items 128 to 132. It mentions the needs, the youth housing scheme, which is really not about the property itself, but that financing scheme, perhaps on how the government is trying to help the youth into owning their first property, right? Owning their property. So what did they mention about this? Okay, so when we review the needs of the youth, home ownership appears to be a big issue, of course. I'm glad to announce the youth housing scheme. That's where it announced, which is a smart partnership between the government, Bank Simpanan Nasional, Employees Provident Fund, and Cagamas. Okay, 129 mentions the scheme offers a funding limit for a first home not exceeding 500,000 for married youth aged between 25 to 40 with household income not exceeding 10,000 ringgit. The maximum loan period is 35 years. So, you know, the first home not exceeding 500,000 ringgit for married youth aged between 25 and 40 years with household income not exceeding 10,000. All right. 130, now this is interesting. The government of the day is going to assist the borrowers for the first 2 years with 200 monthly financial assistance. That's pretty cool. And the second thing is the government will also give a 50% stamp duty exemption on the instrument of transfer agreements and loan agreements. What does the next 2 items mention? Items 131, the government will also provide a 10% loan guarantee to enable borrowers to obtain full financing. Now, this is where they collaborate with Cagamas, and Cagamas is going to guarantee that 10%, which allows the borrower, which is Bank Simpanan Nasional, to give us that 100% loan, right? So that's really cool. It did mention that, you know, borrowers can also withdraw from EPF account to top up their monthly installment and other related costs. And of course, one item 132. Hence, this is a first come, first serve basis for the first 20,000 units. Of course, there are more than 20,000 youth in Malaysia. Of course, youth being 25 to 40 years old. But then again, at least this is a start for something, I guess. Some people might argue it's not enough. Definitely, that's not enough, 20,000. But at least it's a good start. So basically, the 3 areas, the only hints that we got was it will be in Peninsula, it will be in Sabah and Sarawak. So we don't know exactly where it's going to be at. But it's basically these are the 3 areas which just encapsulate the entire Malaysia anyways, right? So maybe you could see how there's a lot of stuff on the youth housing scheme, all right? And we could see, you could see, you know, this website, and it goes direct to mybsn.com website. And you know that this is a collaboration between the government, BSN, and also Cagamas, and it really mirrors what was announced in the budget 2015. At least that's pretty good. Of course, you could look into the frequently asked questions. We're not going to look into that specifically, but that's basically the thing that I wanted to mention under strategy number 6. Under, you know, the allocation of the budget to the youth of Malaysia, they announced Youth City, and of course One Malaysia Youth City, and of course the Youth Housing Scheme, the financing scheme that assists youth to own that property right there. So yep, that's definitely going to impact the property market. We will want to know where they're going to do this One Malaysia Youth City. It could have an impact to the demand and supply of that locality. It could create an extra boost to vibrancy of population, which boosts vibrancy of economy and business right there. So we're gonna keep a close eye on this item right there. So thanks so much for watching this video. We're gonna look into some of the other items that have an impact to the property market in Malaysia in 2015 and beyond. So thanks so much. See you guys in the next video. Bye bye.